Finding a good comp for 3v3 is a science, especially in LFG, where it can feel like you're testing laboratory rats. But no matter whether you're digging through the salt mines of Group Finder or trying to build a team with your homies, you need to know which comps can actually work. And the last time I checked, the WoW manual doesn't show you how to do this, which is why Skillcapped is here for a comp building guide for Shadowlands Season 2. And speaking of Skillcapped, no matter what comp you're trying to build, we got you covered this season. Our website features the biggest collection of arena commentaries on the planet. Our pro players walk you through matchups step by step, teaching you everything you need to know to dominate the competition. And for only $4.99 a month with a money-back guarantee, you have absolutely nothing to lose and all the rating in the world to gain. So if you're ready to take the next step to elevate your gameplay, check out skillcapped.com/wow today. Starting off, we have three melee classes that are really flexible in terms of comp options in 3v3. Arms Warriors, Demon Hunters, and Ret Paladins all work really well in a wide variety of setups. Warriors are probably the most valuable melee DPS you can have on your team, all because of their incredibly dynamic toolkit. And no matter how small their brains are, Warriors have some of the best damage and healing reduction effects in the game, combined with unique control options and multiple team-wide defensives, allowing them to fit into any comp in the game. With key damage buffs and changes to healing reduction effect, Demon Hunters are also quite flexible for comp building, if you can manage to find one that isn't actually insane, which you can determine by the number of alt codes in their name. What they might lack in bulkiness and team-wide defensives, they certainly make up for in damage, where Demon Hunter DPS is some of the highest in Arena, allowing them to solo carry games in LFG. And speaking of soloing, Ret Paladins round out our best melee for LFG comps, due mostly to the strength of their offensive cooldowns. Look, we know that we show Ret Paladin crit montages a lot in our videos, but it's really hard to ignore since their burst is so broken, allowing them to solo kill with limited coordination. I mean, I can't relate, I've never died to a Ret Paladin.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine, when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they...
Anyway, with a bunch of team-wide defensives, Rets are a really safe choice for building any comp, especially in LFG. Moving on, we have three melee that are fairly neutral in comp building, not as flexible as the specs we just mentioned, but worth picking up in Group Finder. Windwalker Monks work well in many comps due to having a healing reduction effect on top of some of the best burst in the game. Unfortunately, their ability to solo carry DPS is offset by their fragility because they die faster than Asmongold loses his hairline. Feral Druids can be a bit of a gamble in LFG because although they are one of the best melee DPS in the game, there is often a massive skill gap between Feral players. You either get juiced out Zoomers with the APM of StarCraft Legends, or you get some stray cat that has fleas and barks like a dog for some reason. But with a healing reduction effect and the ability to bang out one-shots with the new Convoke Legendary, Ferals can be a good pickup in a wide variety of comps. Rounding out our neutral melee DPS picks for 3v3, we have Enhancement Shamans, who have the unique feature of being able to dual-spec mid-game every time Chain Harvest is off CD. But despite nerfs to their off-healing in 9.1, it's still pretty good all things considered, giving them decent defensive flexibility. And of course, Bloodlust gives your team bigger numbers, and last time I checked, I'm pretty sure seeing bigger numbers is a good thing. So if you want a hipster neutral pick for your comp, do the right thing and adopt a Shaman today for 3v3. And moving down to the deepest trenches of the LFG salt mine, we have Rogues and DKs. Obviously, Rogues are good, but unfortunately, they have this hidden stat called Ego that prevents their brain from understanding anything other than RMP. So unless you're wanting to play Diminishing Returns Simulator 3000, we recommend letting the Rogues stick with their mage daddies. And DKs are the ultimate LFG gamble. A mid-tier melee at best, they really need to be hard carried by either Warriors or Windwalkers, since their offensive toolkit is just insanely awkward and they break CC like an excited child popping balloons. So, to recap, here is every melee in the game separated by how flexible they are in comp building. The high flexibility specs will pretty much work with any other DPS. For every class, we have listed the strongest comps available, though there are certainly more viable comps than what you see here. But due to the nature of LFG and its tendency to lack communication, we highly suggest playing the comps we have listed. Now, it's time to move on to casters, once again breaking it down by comp flexibility. Representing our most flexible LFG picks are Shadow Priests and Elemental Shamans. Shadow Priests are the arms warriors of caster DPS, having some of the highest consistent damage combined with tons of team-wide utility. One of the reasons they shine in solo queue environments is that they can cross CC by themselves, being able to chain Psychic Horror and Silence with relative ease for seamless kill setups. Elemental shamans are often ignored, which is a bit of a surprise considering they're represented almost as much as BM hunters on the ladder. What makes them versatile in comp building is the amount of utility they bring to their team, on top of their relatively straightforward win condition based on cooldown stacking to have enough damage to nearly global people. Fire mages and balanced druids are two neutral picks in LFG. Maybe one day they will make a name for this comp. Something like hot turkey cleave? Yeah, that sounds good. If you've seen our tier list, you know that fire mages are one of the god classes of this expansion. With the best control in the entire game and amazing passive defense, they are solid picks for many lineups. The reason they don't quite make the cut, though, is that there are massive skill gaps between many mage players, and although any mage can press combustion and start playing Guitar Hero with pyroblast procs, many mages fail to utilize their control that elevates them to S-tier status. Balanced druids can also be hit or miss in LFG, despite being a high-tier caster. Night Fae may perform better overall with less communication solely because of Convoke, which can easily farm teams at lower ratings. Overall, it's really difficult to form a team around a balanced druid, since their comp options are really limited. Without a Shadow Priest or Elemental Shaman on their team, it can be hard to find win conditions on their own. And finally, we have the rest of our caster lineup failing to find a place in dynamic team building. We've praised both BM and Survival in recent tier list updates, but unfortunately they are single-celled organisms and only have one or two comps at most that suit them for competitive play. Outside of Jungle Cleave, they just really can't keep up with other setups. Warlocks are in a similar position, where they have super limited comp options at the moment, making it difficult to really succeed in LFG. All three specs are good, but can't really carry games on their own in the same way a Shadow Priest can. Finally, both Frost and Arcane Mage need way more experimentation to really solidify them into any 3v3 lineup. With really limited comp options at the moment, we just don't see them outvaluing their oppressive fire overlords. And once again, we have every caster in the game with its ideal DPS partners for 3v3 team building. The high flexibility specs will work well with pretty much every other class in the game, but if you want to have the best chance at farming threes, we suggest sticking to what is listed here. Healers are treated a bit differently than DPS for LFG comp building. Although they might not be the best healer in the game, Holy Paladins are by far the most flexible. With a good mix of both offensive and defensive moves, they are super reliable in any comp archetype. Whether it be melee or wizard cleaves or hybrid setups with warriors, rogues, and mages, Holy Paladins are one of the best choices for any LFG comp. In terms of comp-specific healers, Resto Shamans tend to do best with any melee cleave setup. With really great early game aggression due to the Deep Tremor legendary, they are able to play aggressive with melee DPS by assisting with damage while being super disruptive against casters. And speaking of casters, Resto Druids usually do best when they have one or two wizards on their team. The amount of healing output a druid can do is nearly unmatched, but they lack really strong damage mitigation cooldowns. Because of this, druids often rely on pairing with classes that can slow the game down by spam CCing, or classes that have insanely high bulk. And it's because of this CC and bulk synergy that comps like Mage, Shadow Priest, or WMD do really well with Resto Druid healers. Unfortunately, both priests and monks are fairly limited by comp options and can struggle a lot in LFG lineups. Priests are really strong on their own, but often require really precise coordination with their team in order to win games. Priest comps are usually limited to RMP and Jungle Cleave, with very few options in between. Monks are essentially the budget version of Resto Shamans. While they can work with multiple melee cleave setups, their healing output is fairly limited and will be tested in LFG, where people are typically worse at mitigating damage. So, just to recap, Holy Paladins work really well with a wide variety of setups. Resto Shamans are more specialized for healing melee cleaves, while druids work best with tanky casters and arms warriors. Unfortunately, Mistweaver monks and disc priests are fairly limited in comp options. We have the best comps for each spec listed here, so keep this in mind when building your 3v3 lineup. And when you build a comp, you ideally want to aim to play with at least one of the high flexibility DPS classes, since these will have the best overall synergy with the rest of the lineup. Warriors and Shadow Priests are probably the most flexible specs in the game and are safe picks for any comp. Our neutral options are still good and have a place in many setups, though they lack some of the synergies that allow them to be truly flexible in the chaotic format of LFG. Every spec we have listed here is a safe pick for many comps, though you might want to consider pairing with other highly flexible classes. Unfortunately, there are some classes that have very limited synergies and comp options. Although some of these specs are good on their own, they really need specific partners in order to do well. Make sure you build your comp accordingly, ideally choosing one of the comps we mentioned on our recent 3v3 tier list. And there you have our guide for comp building in Shadowlands Season 2. If you want to see more instructional material, be sure to check out skillcap.com/wow, where we are adding new content for the rest of the season. Hope you all learned something. As always, thanks for watching. See you soon.